Hi, Banana Recap here. Today I'm going to talk about a 2016 movie called Manhattan Nocturne. Enjoy watching it. Meet Porter Wren, a crime reporter for a New York newspaper. In today's world, where almost everyone has a smartphone in their pocket, with which most news is posted immediately on the internet, working at the newspaper does not bring much income for Porter, allowing only to feed himself and his family. At a party thrown by Tycoon Hobbs, Porter meets a charming girl named Caroline Crowley. Understanding that the girl wants something from him, Wren asks a question, to which Caroline offers to answer at her home. In the girl's apartment, Caroline hands Porter an envelope with documents about the death of her husband, Simon Crowley, a famous movie director, including photos from the scene and police reports, which say that Simon's body was found in the ruined building, but how it got there is unknown, because the area around the building is fenced with a high fence, and Simon did not have the keys to the front gate. After studying the documents and getting pretty wasted, Porter returns home. Arriving at the newsroom in the morning, Porter unwraps a piece of paper with Caroline's phone number, which the girl wrote to him last night. Printing out the gum, which says on the insert that there may not be another chance, Porter calls the girl. Upon arriving at her house, Wren questions the girl about the time she met Simon Crowley. According to Caroline, she met Simon at a bar where she went after she was fired from her job for refusing to go on a date with the head of the law firm where the girl worked as a secretary. They had a nice chat with Simon, who a couple of hours after they met, proposed to the girl, to which Caroline said yes. 3 days later, the couple secretly got married. 6 months of happy married life ended after Simon didn't come home one day. Caroline was worried, but she didn't call the police, because she knew for sure if Simon found out, he would freak out. But 3 days later, the girl realized that something had happened to her husband. The police never solved this murder, so the girl turned to Porter, because very often people entrust their secrets to this guy, since many people know him. Wren pronounces that people tell him their stories simply because they want others to know about them, but Caroline is looking for something else. Taking his coat, Porter leaves the girl's apartment, but finds that he left his phone behind. He returns, dialing the lock code since the girl didn't open the door. Taking the phone from the table, Porter realizes that Caroline is taking a shower. As he sneaks up to the ajar door, the guy notices the girl satisfying herself. Caroline notices Porter, who apologizes to the girl. Caroline wonders if the guy enjoyed watching her, admitting that she was just thinking about him in the shower room. After telling the girl that the opportunity only knocks once, Porter begins kissing the girl, after which they engage in cupcake making. After cheating on his spouse, Porter returns home. Taking an advance retroactively from Caroline, Wren begins his investigation into the death of her husband Simon. Each time, Porter convinces himself not to see the girl again, because he's a family man, but once Caroline calls the guy, he offers to have lunch together. Even though the girl has a boyfriend, she doesn't feel any guilt towards him, calling herself a free woman. Caroline has something she only wants to show Porter. The girl takes Wren to the bank, where a briefcase with flash drives containing Simon's records is kept. Caroline leaves Porter to look through the tapes, as she says she has seen them many times and it would be tedious for her. After a while, Porter's phone receives a call. The voice on the phone informs him that Porter wants to see Hobbs, the current owner of the newspaper where the guy works. As he walks out of the bank, Porter notices a man he has seen following him several times before. Wren rushes after him, but he manages to slip away. Arriving at Mr. Hobbs, Porter learns that the tycoon knows all about his affair with Caroline, who constantly sends Mr. Hobbs the same tape with dirt on the man without asking for any money. Porter's assignment is to get to the bottom of this. Since Hobbs is very influential, he begins to intimidate the guy not only by getting fired, but also by fabricating cases against him. Hobbs is well aware of the fact that Porter's family lives mostly on the salary of his wife Lisa, a very good surgeon, but even that Hobbs is able to influence and take away her job. When he arrives home, Porter learns from Lisa that a very strange, 28-year-old patient came to see her today complaining of joint pain, which is not at all typical for such an age, but on examination Lisa found nothing. Upon arriving at the girl's house, Porter informs her that he has something for her. Caroline has something for Porter, too, so she offers to put it off until later. After a bit of sniping, the girl begins to question Porter about Lisa. Ren assumes that it was Caroline who came to see Lisa yesterday, to which the girl agrees. What prompted Caroline to do this is her curiosity. Lisa is very clever, so Porter asks the girl not to see his wife again. In turn, Caroline asks Porter if he thinks about her when he does cupcake with his wife.
Да.
Caroline wants to know if Porter is in love with her.
Со дня нашей первой встречи.
The guy's not comfortable with Hobbs' assignment, so he asks Caroline directly about the tape being sent to his boss. The girl admits it's not her. Caroline had hoped that Porter was just wearing that tape while investigating Simon's murder. Who sends it to Hobbs, the girl doesn't know, but Caroline knows what's on it, since she was present when it was shot. According to her story, Simon was constantly testing the girl to find a limit to her abilities. They made a condition to each other on Caroline's demand: Simon must hold the dying man's hand, and Caroline must sleep with someone unexpected, a chauffeur or some gardener would not do too trivial. That night the girl saw Hobbs. She had seen him on television, so she recognized him at once. Finding out which hotel room he was staying in, the girl sneaks in, where she films everything that happens on the spy pen camera handed to her by Hobbs. Porter concludes that everything that happened between him and the girl is a staged scene to get Porter to find that tape, which Caroline herself confirms. Realizing that he is being used, Porter goes home, where Hobbs's men meet him at the door, demanding to give him the tape. Waking up in the morning, Lisa finds Porter beaten in the bathroom, who lies to his wife that he was attacked by burglars. The next day, Porter goes to the nursing home, where he meets Simon's father, asking the old man about the flash drives. Receiving no answer from Frank, Porter searches his room, finding a video camera in his nightstand, from which he removes a memory card. At that moment, a text message arrives on his phone from Lisa. Upon arriving at the hospital, Porter learns that some man shot his son and babysitter with a gun when he broke into their apartment. To keep his family safe, Porter decides to get to Hobbs. It is possible to do this through his confidant Campbell. Putting a noose around his neck, Ren demands to call Hobbs and call off the thugs, stabbing Campbell in the thigh to be more convincing. After contacting the billionaire, Porter demands he leave his family alone or he will make 1,000 copies of that video and send it to all the media in the world, to which Hobbs gives the guy 24 hours to deliver the video, or everything that happened to him will be kindergarten compared to what's ahead of him. Back at home, Porter looks at the tape on the flash drive he stole from Simon's father. There's nothing much in the video, just a plea for Frank not to blame himself for what happens later. The video also features an old lady, Mrs. Siegel, who has been visiting Frank at the nursing home very often. Porter goes to see the old lady, but no one answers his calls deep into the night. Finding the key to the front door, Porter makes his way inside. Digging through the bills, Ren hears a noise. There is no way out of the house, so he hides behind the door. When the footsteps stop, Porter looks out of the room, meeting Mrs. Siegel. The old lady tries to call the police, but Porter begs him not to, calling her by her name. The old lady is the only clue to Simon's death, so Porter asks for her help by showing her identification. The old lady recognizes the journalist because she reads his articles all the time. According to Mrs. Siegel, Simon and her son Michael were childhood friends. Michael drowned when he was 8 years old, and Simon kept dropping by after his mother died, becoming almost a son to Mrs. Siegel. Once Simon started earning money, he continually sent $2,000 each to Mrs. Siegel as a gesture of goodwill. But the bills that Porter saw showed a very different amount, $5,000. According to the old lady, she received this money from Simon's firm for sending flash drives. Mrs. Siegel pronounces that she has one last flash drive left, which she gives to Porter. Ren watches a tape of Caroline seducing Hobbs, but he admits to the girl that he has problems with his manhood, which he lost in a fight when he was young. Caroline also shares her story with the billionaire, which Porter cannot hear because they are talking very quietly, whereupon Hobbs suggests that she not use her tongue but use it for its intended purpose. Realizing that this was the tape Hobbs was looking for, Porter hands the flash drive to the billionaire. The case seems to be hushed up, but Hobbs reveals that they searched Caroline's apartment for the flash drive and found a key that didn't fit any of the doors. With this key, Porter goes the next day to where Simon's body was found. The key given by Hobbs opens the door of a tunnel that led to the basements of both buildings. One of the buildings, where Crowley's body was found, had been demolished, but the other, an exact replica of the demolished one, remained. There the journalist met a security guard whom he had seen earlier. According to the man's story, the elevator in the demolished building was downstairs in the basement of the house, and the police did not search anything because the elevator was under a thick layer of soil. After hiring a crew to dig up the elevator at the demolished building, Porter makes his way inside. There he discovers a device to which several cameras have been connected. In the footage, Crowley shows Caroline the horse Hobbs gave her after the girl told her story in the hotel room. This horse figurine is worth a fabulous amount of money. Simon doesn't want to let Caroline out until he hears the same story, because on the tape they talk quietly and can't hear anything, but the story is too personal for the girl. Simon smashes the horse, after which he straps Caroline into the elevator and swallows the key. Crowley pulls it down and the elevator pulls the girl down with it. To avoid being killed, Caroline agrees to tell what happened in her childhood. Simon stops the elevator, and the girl grabs a leg from the horse figure and sticks it in her husband's neck. To free herself from the chain, Caroline needs the key that Simon swallowed. The girl rips her ex-husband's stomach open, which Porter sees in the footage. Going upstairs, Wren calls Caroline, telling her he found the tape and gave it to Hobbs. The girl asks to meet and shows Porter the engagement ring Caroline got from her boyfriend. Porter has something to show her, too. With these words, he pulls out the head from the horse figure found in the demolished building. Taking out the key Hobbs handed him, Porter tells him that Simon's murder was caught on camera. After retrieving the key from Simon's stomach, Caroline frees herself and then wraps the same chain around the tunnel door so that no one will find Crowley's body. Porter shows the flash drive, explaining that it is a copy and he hid the original. Wren demands that Caroline never show up at his wife Lisa's house again. Wishing the girl happiness, Porter leaves. That's the end of the movie. Thanks for watching and see you on the channel.